poison, I see, hath been his timeless end. Oh, churl, drunk all and left no friendly drop. Oh, happy dagger, this is thy sheath. There, rust, and let me die. The door slammed shut. Please wait a minute. I'll find the spare key.
Hi, I'm Dreyer Crowley. Oh, what a wonderful performance. That was clearly not an act, but a veritable display of the feelings of two hearts in love. I'm holding a ball tonight. You must perform there. I promise you will be incredibly famous. You do realize that you'll starve if you stay in this dump, don't you? Your talent shouldn't be wasted here in the middle of nowhere. I'll ask the owners of some major theaters to give you a role in their famous plays. All the guests are already waiting at my estate. If you agree, we need to go right now, or you may not have the time to prepare anything.
Mr. Crowley, thank you for your generous offer, but we must wait for Franz. He went to get pieces of scenery for the next show.
We can't waste another minute. Leave Franz a note telling him to meet us at the estate. I have a little gift for you. Take it. This will come in handy.
Dear Franz, you won't believe it, but fortune smiled on us. Dreyer Crowley invited us to perform at the ball at his estate. I have to go now, or we won't be able to prepare everything on time. We'll be waiting for you at the estate. Lots of love. Your Beatrice.
It's a pretty long drive to my estate. Would you mind passing the time by having a glass or two? Let's drink to your talent, young lady.
Mr. Crowley invited us to perform at the ball. What luck! I need to hurry to the estate. Beatrice's pendant? What happened here? She would never leave it. too noisy in the estate. Nobody will hear me.
Welcome. My name is Eve. I'm Mr. Crawley's butler. He said you were coming. Mr. Crawley is expecting you in his office on the second floor. The ball will begin soon, so I have to go. You may go to the office for now.
Hello, my name is Margaret Boleyn, and I'm an owner of some of the major theatres in the city. I'm also a longtime friend of Mr. Crowley's family. Wait, I know you. I saw your performance at the local theatre. You must be looking for your fiancée. She's already with Mr. Crowley in his office. He put in a word for you, and I would be happy to give you a job at one of my theatres. I was just about to go upstairs when I suddenly twisted my leg. The heel broke, and now I can't go anywhere. And please, think of something to help me. In return, I'll take you to the second floor to see Mr. Crowley. Ah, my leg! Thank you. These shoes fit perfectly. You're very lucky, young boy. Your fiancé is probably tired of waiting for you. Follow me. I'll take you to Crowley's office. And here, take it as a token of my gratitude.
I'm Augustin. I'm in charge of a private event at Mr. Crowley's estate. Today he's holding a closed meeting of the gaming club. Only noble gentlemen are allowed to play, but as an exception, I can let you in if you're ready to try your luck. You will not be disappointed. I'll be waiting for you inside.
Oh, this family has such a sad story.
Today is an exceptional day at Mr. Crowley's estate. We have special prizes waiting just for you. The first one is the portrait of Mr. Crowley's longtime love. There are only a few people out there who were lucky enough to see her in person. Make sure you have enough chips to make a bet. Here, this might be useful as well.
The Crowleys had always been prosperous and famous. Dreyer's father, Martin, was a renowned philanthropist. He invested a lot of money in the city theater and thus revived it. At one point, Martin Crowley started gambling. His favorite was a game of cards. In just 1 year, he had lost his entire fortune. Their family ended up on the street. Dreyer's mother, Annabel, was fond of her son. Shortly after their bankruptcy, she caught an unknown disease. The family had no money for her treatment. Soon, Dreyer lost his mother. Two strangers were waiting for Martin Crowley in a dark alley. Death was the payment for his debts. A musket bullet struck Martin in the heart. His boy was sent to an orphanage. Dreyer grew up and surprised the city with his outstanding achievements. Fortune smiled upon him. Soon, he bought out the Crowley estate and restored the family's reputation.
Good evening, Franz. Oh, look at you. Your acting skills can impress anyone.
Where's Beatrice?
She's here. I need her loving heart. It's the price I pay to be with great and beautiful Fortuna. I could easily kill you, but gambling is a weakness of mine. Let's find out whose side Fortuna is on today. The wager will be... Beatrice, if you win, you'll have a chance to see her one last time. You must get a 6 on each die.
Oh, you lovebirds are so stupid. Your feelings cloud your judgment and bring out your reckless side. Franz has already made it to Dreyer's trap. Maybe now is exactly the moment your love gambles away your soul to Dreyer.
Wager will be Beatrice. If you win, you'll have a chance to see her one last time. You must get a 6 on each die.
Franz! Franz, I'm here!
fool! You've just lost your lover's soul. You were completely safe until this very moment. I wasn't able to take the soul unless one of you agreed to gamble on it and lost. Now, Beatrice is mine, and you, I don't need you anymore.
No! Stop it!
From now on, Beatrice, you are just one more card in my collection. A new, obedient puppet.
Is there anything I can do for you, Mr. Crowley?
Get this chap to the wine cellar. Don't forget the cuffs. Other servants will help you. Meanwhile, I'll sacrifice this pretty lady in the name of Fortuna. My infinite luck awaits me. You were my backup plan in case something happens to Beatrice. But seriously, Franz, you're causing way too many problems, and I don't have time for that. Not only have you gambled away your beloved soul, but also linked your own one to this card. Look, I'll tear it, and your life is over.
No! Wrong!
You've caused too much trouble, darling, and I'm losing my temper. This will settle you. Much better. Oh, the sweet sense of control. All thanks to this card. I hope you've learned your lesson. Now, I'll go and get the ritual paraphernalia. Play nice while I'm gone. What have you done, you little thief? You pay for this!
Hey! Sir! Right here! Help me!
Hey, are you all right, sir? I'm Gilbert, Mr. Crowley's gardener. I've been serving this family for so long. When Dreyer lost his parents, he became a completely different person. Something or someone had changed him. A kind and caring boy had turned into... I did try to talk some sense into this new Dreyer, but he wouldn't listen. I can't help thinking that there was something I could have done to prevent him from spiraling out of control. There must be a way to bring kind Dreyer back. I feel you're a good man, so I'll help you. Here, I believe you need it.
Oh, thank God! I'm glad you feel much better. I suppose your beloved's all you have on your mind right now. Let me think. You may still find some clues regarding Beatrice's whereabouts at the estate. The only problem is Eve. She's still there. I'll do my best to distract her. Don't waste another minute. Go! And here, take this. It may come in handy. Thank you.
Dreyer hid all the things needed for the ritual in the city museum he'd recently opened. I'm sure he's taking Beatrice there.
Minutes.
thanks. What would I do without you? Dreyer will be back soon. We'd better get away from this place. Listen, sir. Mr. Crowley kidnapped me. He was going to sacrifice me in the name of some spirit. Please believe me.
Calm down, madam. I'll help you. This way, please.
Something's wrong. This road won't get us to the city. I bet this gendarme is a good friend of Dreyer's. He wasn't even going to help us. I'll distract him. You jump out of the carriage. Now!
Hi, I'm Ernesto, a local forester. I'm surprised to see a young lady here in the middle of the forest. People aren't frequent visitors here. What happened? Are you in trouble? Oh, of course. I'll help you as soon as you rest properly. Of course you can. There may be some of my sister's clothes up there in the attic. She didn't manage to take all of it when moving to the city. Go there and take whatever you'll find. Are you hungry, dear? This adventure must have cost you a lot of energy. I knew it.
My kitchen is at your disposal. Feel free to take everything you need. And here, this can come in handy. just remembered how I know you. You are the actress from our local theater, right? I've made it to your performance once. You did great. I think I saw Franz running into the thicket. This forest is easy to get lost in and get into trouble. Luckily, I know every nook and cranny and can be your guide. I'll be waiting outside. Here, take this. You never know what can come in handy.
I look at the egg yolks and see little suns. Oh, Clarice, I miss your smile. You were my son, and now when you're gone, I have to live in the darkness. These are the apples my dear wife Clarice used to make her signature apple pie. Clarice's secret to fluffy dough is a particular mixing technique. One must mix the dough 3 minutes clockwise and 2 minutes counterclockwise. Oh, the pie tastes heavenly!
You ride this horse, and I'll ride the other one. Let's go.
Ernesto, my loyal servant, you did wonderfully, as usual. Bravo!
The clock is ticking, Dreyer. I hope you found a quality heart. Otherwise, I'll end your pathetic existence.
Ernesto, you've heard her. We need to hurry. Check her. This pretty one has stolen the card.
Oh, damn it, stupid girl. Mr. Crowley will be deeply disappointed at her death. The good news is I don't need you anymore. Goodbye, Romeo.
diary says Crowley sacrifices these poor girls at the building in the city square. But wait, where's the next page? No, no, no! Which building was Ernesto talking about? Where's he hiding you, Beatrice?
Of the ritual is nigh. This whole Franz to the rescue thing only whets my appetite. I bet he's making one more pathetic attempt to save you at this exact moment. Well, there are some finishing touches I need to make before the ritual. You behave yourself. Be back in a minute.
Franz. Right here, on the roof. Please look up, please.
Ring all you can, darling. This Beatrice is trying to escape her fate play is so amusing. The momentous hour has come. Soon, you'll meet the great Fortuna, and we'll find out for whom the bell tolls. We have one more viewer. Great. Do you, Franz, agree that life is a play? Both of you must realize the importance of a role choice. You either have power, or someone has power over you. I've chosen the first option, so everyone else is just a soulless vessel.
puppets without any purpose to their existence. The cards in my deck.
Beatrice, Franz, that was magnificent. Congratulations. Franz, you helped me with my shoe situation. Now it's time for me to keep my promise. Meet me at my theater, both of you.
Everything is going to be great. I know it.
Never take it off. A part of me will always be by your side.